Hey guys, in this lecture we will show some of the most common chart types, useful terms and chart areas of them. Keep in mind that you don't really need to memorize these terms. The more we use Excel charts, the more we become familiar with. Let's begin. We see a table with data. To the right of our data, we see one of Excel's most common chart types. As you see, as I slide the mouse over without clicking, the outer area of the chart is called chart area. The inner area is the plot area. Below the cluster column chart, we see a pie chart. The outer area is the chart area and we can find the plot area if we slide the mouse near the pie. Below the data, we have the line chart with the chart area and the plot area. Chart and plot areas are not the only in the chart. For example, if you see the 3D cluster column chart, which is below the line chart, it has areas called back wall, side wall, floor, and of course the chart and plot area. Another term of the chart is data label. Let's point our mouse to the upper line in line chart. It will show information about this particular line, like series, word, point, 2013 value, 525. Terms like data label, series, point, and values we will see again as we continue to the course. Most of the charts have horizontal and vertical gray lines, helping us to see specific numbers or values. For example, in line chart we slide the mouse over and we have vertical value axis major grid lines. Now, what is a legend? A legend is an area, usually on the right or on the bottom of the chart, which helps us to decode the chart data. Column chart has legend on the bottom, and so is each program, Excel, PowerPoint, with different color, of course. So it's easy to find it on the chart, especially if we have a lot of data. If you remember from the school, most maps had legends. All of our charts in this particular worksheet have legends on the bottom. Now, if we want to make changes to chart elements, we can just click on it. After that, we have two options. First, we can right-click and choose the option Format Chart Area. The second option is that we can go to the Format tab. The Format tab is very useful because it has the term Chart Area with a drop arrow. If we click on it, we can see all the elements of a chart. We choose an element from the list and it is automatically selected. So very useful, especially if we cannot right-click on a specific element of a chart. Hey guys, welcome back. In this lecture we will understand which type of chart I will choose. The thing is that there is no specific chart type that is ideal for all kinds of data, so it depends on the data we have. The most common kind of chart, especially in the business industry, is cluster column chart, used most of the time to show volumes. Of course, there are many variations of a column chart. Line charts are common too, especially if we want to show a trend. A pie chart is common for showing data, months, years, etc., and also used for company presentations. A bar chart is a column chart rotated 90 degrees. The difference of a column chart is that data moves from left to right. If we have volumes to compare, maybe an area chart is what we want. Less common charts are scatter charts, which are commonly used for displaying and comparing numeric values, like statistical data. Bubble chart, like scatter. Stock chart. Surface chart, a three-dimensional surface, are useful when we want to find optimum combinations between two sets of data. Radar chart, also known as a spider chart, and finally combo charts, are useful if we want to compare different kinds of values. There are hundreds of variations for each of the basic charts. And there are more advanced chart types that we will learn, like Pareto, also known as 80-20% chart, Gantt chart, frequency chart, and of course the impressive dynamic charts. If we want to change the chart type, we simply choose the chart. Go to the ribbon and click the Design tab. Now, we click the Change Chart Type tool and choose the chart we want. It's important to see the new ribbon called Chart Tools. It appears when we click on a chart. It consists of two tabs, Design and Format tab. Design tab has to do with the various features we see on a chart. Format tab has to do with visuals. A nice characteristic of Excel 2013 is live preview. For example, in the Design tab, look at chart styles. It's a fantastic feature because we see a preview of a choice before we click on it. It also helps us to try before we select. If we click outside the chart, in a cell for example, with a mouse, then Chart Tools disappears. If we double click on a chart, a Format Chart Area dialog box appears to the right side. We can move this dialog box wherever we want. Move it left, and then right again. And look, it sticks like a magnet. Okay, close it now. The same dialog box appears when we right click and choose Format Chart Area option. Hey guys, and welcome back. So the first step to create a chart is selecting the data. It's better to not include totals for now and put all the data together. After selecting data, we press Alt and F1. It's the quickest way to create a default chart, which is clustered column chart. Press Ctrl+Z to undo. Another method is simply click on a cell of our data and press again Alt and F1. Excel is smart enough to select all the data of the table, but with this method, Excel includes all the columns like totals in our table, so be careful. Undo again. If we want to select non-adjacent areas, for example, the first column with programs and column with totals, then we will use the Control key. We select first these cells, press Control, and select totals. Again, Alt F1, and chart is ready, with the selected columns, of course. Until now, we created a chart in the same worksheet with our data, but sometimes it's better to have a chart in a new worksheet. This method is simple. We highlight the cells of our data with the mouse, and then we press the F11 key. A chart will appear on a new worksheet called Chart 1. It shows only the chart with no distraction from our data. Of course, by making changes to the values of our data, the chart will be changing, even though it is in a different worksheet. Let's see it in practice. Go to Data worksheet, change cell B3 and type 500. Enter, then go to Chart 1 and see the difference. Press Undo from this button now. When we select data, in the lower right corner, a quick analysis tool pops up. It has 5 different tab settings like formatting, charts, totals, tables, and sparklines. We will show most of these new features as we continue to the course. We can, for example, create a chart easily. Pretty fast method. If the default chart isn't that we want, then after selecting data, we click Insert tab from the ribbon and we see a number of choices relating to the specific chart category. Each category of a chart has many choices, simply by clicking the arrow or the icon. Finally, Excel 2013 has a lovely new function, the recommended charts, which is again on the Insert tab and is ideal for new Excel users. With this method, Excel recommended us charts that they think will best fit with our data. If we don't like recommended charts, we can choose from All Charts tab, the one that we believe is best for our data table. Thanks for watching. Yeah.